Choosing the best file sharing service can be tricky, but not to worry. We've done the legwork for you and put together some pros and cons of top file sharing apps, Dropbox and Box. This video will dive into these tools so you can make an easier decision for your team. Okay, let's get started with Dropbox. Dropbox at its core is a file sharing service that's focused on creating products for individuals rather than businesses. But that's not to say it doesn't have a business version available for teams. Here are a few pros of Dropbox. Firstly, there are a wide range of uses for stored files. Teams can assign stored files to other teammates or third parties, add notes, set due dates, attach files to calendar invites, and more. Secondly, Dropbox also has top-notch security features. Dropbox offers excellent security to protect confidential information in stored files, including two-factor authentication and sharing controls. Lastly, Dropbox also offers affordable plans for under $10 per month, which is great for teams on a budget. The biggest con of Dropbox is that the enterprise accounts can be complex to set up. Dropbox partners need to conduct complex or large-scale deployments when setting up enterprise accounts. Now, on to Box. Box, on the other hand, is a file-sharing app that's made an effort to market its services to larger organizations and teams. But don't be fooled, it does offer free individual plans too. Here are a few Box pros. First, Box has a huge emphasis on its security. It has some incredible security features, such as allowing its users to encrypt files and offering tools to ensure GDPR compliance. Second, Box offers customized assistance from experts. Companies can hire Box experts and specialists to improve existing processes, integrate Box into current workflows, and more. Lastly, Box offers free and inexpensive plans for teams on a budget. Now, let's jump into the biggest con of Box. Box has restrictions on free and lower cost plans. The limitations on Box's plans are more restrictive than those offered by competitors. If you're giving Box a test run for the first time, you won't be able to access many of its features with an individual plan. So there you have it, Dropbox versus Box. Now, which one will you choose for your organization? Let us know in the comments and be sure to subscribe to our channel.